Burroughs. Amen.
Amen.
Let us all stand around the church with the exception of the family as we sing our opening hymn, Blessed Assurance, with the gospel and senior choir.
Minister Melanie Harrington.
Amen.
board, everybody, and welcome to the Burroughs family. Our heartfelt sympathy and condolences go out to you. I thank you again for trusting me to do this portion of the service. We command you for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Yes. And to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. Yes. Let us prepare our hearts and our minds as we go before a throne of grace. Heavenly Father, we come before you, O God, on this day, giving you glory and honor and praise just for who you are. Because you are a good God. Hallelujah. And we thank you for this gathering on today, Lord God, that we gather to celebrate the life of your dear daughter. God, we thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah. That we can look to the hills from whence cometh our help and know our help comes from you. So God, at this time, we ask that you would send help to this family, Lord God. As they go through that time of mourning, as they go through their night season, oh God. Hallelujah. But we thank you, God, that you're ever present, oh God. You said you'd never leave us nor forsake us. So God, you're with them right now. Even if they're feeling lonely. Even, God, in the void of the separation, this earthly separation. But God, we know that once we leave this place, because it's only temporary, and we're just passing through. We thank you, God, that she has gone from labor to reward, God, and has entered into heaven, God, in eternal rest. So God, we're grateful on today, Lord God, for the life that she lived. And for God, allowing her 90 plus years on this earth. Thank you for the lives that she impacted, oh God. For the hearts that she touched, oh God. Hallelujah. God, I thank you, Lord God, on a personal note, God, that she came into my life and helped me to care and take care and raise my children from infancy. And they are adults now, God. So God, I thank you, Lord God, for the impact that she had on our lives through the years, God. And I ask, oh God, that you will send your comfort to this family, Lord God. Even in their loneliness, God, allow the healing, God, to begin with the memories, oh God. And every tear that is shed, oh God. Thank you for the washing, oh God. Hallelujah. And that they know you, oh God, in the pardon of their sins. So God, we thank you that she was saved, delivered, and set free from this dying world. Hallelujah. And that, God, she looked to you, God, the author and finisher of her faith. Oh God, hallelujah. Knowing that once she passed this life, God, that it wasn't the end, God. But God, she's now resting, completely whole, God, completely healed, oh God. Hallelujah. And we thank you for all that you've done for her, God, for all that you're doing for her family, God. Hallelujah. Let them continue to look to you, Lord God, for everything, God. Send your peace that surpasseth all understanding, oh God, to them. Let it rest on them, God, in the name of Jesus. And God, we're so careful, oh God, to continue to give you the glory, the honor, and the praise as you shepherd the rest of this family, God, as they go through their journey of life. And we thank you. And it is in Jesus' name that we pray. And we say amen. 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 To God be the glory.
Strength of my life.
as we come to this bittersweet moment, we lift up praises for the life, and I take liberty in calling her Mom Burroughs, amen, because she was certainly a mother figure to me. So I thank and praise God that I can stand in this pulpit today and honor her life, amen. And as we bring encouragement to this family through the Word of God, we will now have our scripture read by Reverend Stady Reeves. Old Testament and New Testament will be read by Maganza Davis. Amen.
Amen, church. I'll be reading from Isaiah, the 57th chapter, verse 1 and 2. Isaiah, the 57th chapter, verse 1 and 2. The righteous perish, and no one takes it to heart. The devout are taken away, and no one understands that the righteous are taken away to be spared from evil. Those who walk uprightly enter into peace. They find rest as they lie in death. Be blessed.
All our eyes on you, Lord. been you, Lord. All I trust in you, Lord. All we want is you, Lord. See, the Lord is our shepherd. The Lord is our helper. No. Thank you.
resolutions and acknowledgments by Sister Yvonne Allman. Oh, by Brother Kevin Brooks.
Just this one.
Amen. Praise God.
Good morning, everybody. Good afternoon, actually. On behalf of the Hostess Ministry of St. James A.M.E. Church, I'd like to read this resolution. And resolution in loving memory of Mrs. Margaret Lois Burroughs, Saturday, August 5th, 2023. Face to face, we shall behold him, far beyond the starry sky. Face to face, on his glory, we shall see him by and by. Whereas God, in his infinite wisdom and everlasting mercy, call from labor to reward his faithful servant, Margaret Lois Burroughs, on Thursday, July 27, 2023. And whereas Mrs. Burroughs was married to Goldburn L. Burroughs, and to this union four children were born, Goldburn, Maganza, Brian, and Brenda. And whereas she was a member of the Hostess Club and past president, she enjoyed traveling with them away and going locally. Whereas we are unable to comfort the family adequately, we commend you the reassuring and counseling spirit of Jesus Christ. It is written in 1 Thessalonians 4, chapter 14, verse to the 17th verse, for if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so then also which sleep in Jesus will God's loving memory be with him. For this we say unto you, by the word of the Lord shall we shout, with the voice of the archangel and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall arise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever will be with the Lord. Wherefore comfort one another with these words. Now be it resolved that with the pastor, the officers and members of St. James A.M.E. Church, the Hostess Ministry, we extend our deep and heartfelt sympathy to you, the family. And be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the family and a copy placed on the archives of St. James A.M.E. Church. We will swallow up death for all time, and the Lord God will wipe our tears away from all faces, and he will remove the reproach of his people from all the earth, for the Lord has spoken. Isaiah 25th chapter, the 8th verse. Done by the Hostess Ministry, Mrs. Rose Bishop, who is standing next to me, president, Reverend Dr. James Coaxum III, pastor. Thank you.
Praise God for what God has done in this homegoing service thus far. We give him the honor, we give him the glory, and we give him the praise. I have the distinct honor of reading the resolutions. And Mother Burroughs was loved by so many. And I have so many resolutions here that I'm not going to be able to read them all. So I am going to read a few, and then I will acknowledge the others. And the family will get back in touch with you with their thanks at a later date. Forever remembered. Thinking of you with caring thoughts and deepest condolences and deepest sympathy, peace and blessings, Sandra Rahu Thompson. From Ozeal Grand Chapter, message of condolence. Fifth day of August in the year of our Lord 2023. As for me, I am already being poured out as a libation. and the time of my departure has come. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, there is reserved for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing. 2 Timothy 4, 6-8. To the family of Sister Margaret Lois Burroughs, past District Deputy Grand Matron, the officers and members of O'Zeal Grand Chapter Order of the Eastern Star, Prince Hall, affiliation for the jurisdiction of New Jersey, wish to extend our heartfelt and deepest sympathy to Sister Brenda L. Burroughs, Grand Secretary Emeritus, and family, as you celebrate the life of your loved one, Sister Margaret L. Burroughs, past District Deputy Grand Matron. The break in your family chain has been felt deeply by every member of the order. We are saddened to hear about the transition of Sister Margaret Burroughs from earth to heaven. We know how difficult this must be for the entire family. You showed us in a wonderful and loving way the true role of family from generation to generation through the love, unity, and appreciation of one another. But God loved her more. Sister Burroughs will be missed dearly, and we know your heart still only sorrow and profound sadness. We pray that Jesus will bless you with resilient hearts and renewed spirit as he holds you in his everlasting arms and comfort you with the depths of his love. Philippians 1:3 reads, I thank my God upon every remembrance of you. This is one of the most precious gifts that God has given us, the ability to remember. We all have hurts and disappointments in the life that we should forget. But good memories become a treasure chest of priceless reminders of relationships shared and joys experienced. Cherish your memories, for they will provide you with the peace, comfort, and joy that will keep you together in spirit. To you, her loving daughter, Brenda, and all the family, Mom will always be watching over you. May God's presence give you comfort, and the love of family and friends be a source of comfort to all the family members during this time of bereavement. Yours in Christ and fraternal bond, Sister Marjorie P. Ellis, Grand Worthy Matron, Brother Kevin G. Thomas, Grand Worthy Patron, the officers and members of O'Zeal Grand Chapter, Order of the Eastern Star, Prince Hall Affiliates for the jurisdiction of New Jersey. And we have a letter of condolence from the past Grand Worthy Matron and past Grand Worthy Patrons of O'Zeal Chapter, and we've just heard from them from the Eastern Star, but I will read briefly. God looked around his garden, and he found an empty place. He then looked down upon this earth and saw past Matron Sister Margaret Lois Burroughs' face. He put his arms around her and lifted her to rest. God's garden must be beautiful. He always takes the best. And I'm not going to read the rest, but 2 Timothy 4:17 says, I have fought a good fight, I have finished my course, and I have kept the faith, no matter how difficult the fight seems. And respectfully submitted on the 6th day of August, 2023, past Grand Worthy Matron Reverend Dr. Sister Carolyn Hayes Simmons, Council President, past Grand Worthy Matron Sister Janice Justice, Vice President, past Grand Worthy Matron Sister Donna Robinson, Secretary. We have acknowledgments from the Azor Court 14, and that is Karen Hicks, illustrious commandress, and a test Gloria, written over Gloria Elias. I can't see it, it's written, we're sorry. And we're going to acknowledge the Mount Royal Court, number 10, Atlantic City, New Jersey. And there is a scripture, let not your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And that is from the order of Dorothy Garlick, Kevin D. Thomas, and Gloria G. Elsie. And we also have an acknowledgement from Rahab Court, number 15, State of New Jersey. And I'll be, and be it further resolved that this resolution be given to the family of Karen Margaret L. Burroughs, past most ancient matron, and a copy be placed in the permanent records of Red Court number 15. And I'm going to read the senior choir, St. James Ambie Church Senior Choir Resolution in memory of Sister Margaret Lois Burroughs. Saturday, August the 5th, 2023. If you miss me singing down here, if you miss me singing down here, oh, come on up to bright glory, I'll be singing up there. Whereas we, the officers and members of St. James Ambie Church Senior Choir, are deeply saddened by the passing of our beloved Sister Margaret Lois Burroughs on Thursday, July 27th, 2023. God decided that she had fought the good fight, finished her course, and kept course and kept the faith. So he summoned her to heaven to experience the eternal joy of Jesus. And whereas Sister Margaret was a dedicated member of the senior choir who joined when the Richard Allen Gospel Chorus merged with the senior choir, she attended rehearsals regularly and sang faithfully, serving as the financial secretary for over 20 years. She participated in the annual Christmas party, the wedding of the Four Seasons, and other choir activities, giving generously of her time, talent, and resources. And whereas she was a much-loved jewel who lived her Christianity, she loved the Lord, her family, her pastor, and St. James AME Church. She was a good friend and would assist in any way that she could. And whereas she has a sense of calm and compassion that attracted others to her, we enjoyed being in her company and laughing at her humorous antics. Her sweet spirit characterized her throughout her life and inspired her children. Inspired other relatives, choir members, friends, and fraternal sisters. And whereas she loved the pipe organ and the hymns of the church, especially Blessed Assurance, and Just Close of Walk with Thee. And whereas we love her, but God loved her best. Now she is safe in the arms of Jesus, enjoying the wonders of his kingdom. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the officers and members of St. James AME Senior Choir express our sincere and heartfelt sympathy to her sons, Ober Jr. and Brian, daughters McGanza Davis and Brenda Burroughs, her sister-in-law Lucille Kennedy, Lillian Rome, and Suzette Vegatano, her grandchildren, nieces, nephews, godchildren, and a host of other family members and her friends. And be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the Burroughs family and a copy placed in the files of St. James AME Church Senior Choir. Sorrowfully submitted, St. James AME Church Senior Choir, Dr. Juanita J. Hyde, President, Sister Ruth Meese, Recording Secretary, Pastor Reverend Dr. James Coaxum III. We have one from St. James here, and we have three from St. James Base Landing, and I'm going to acknowledge two of them. I'm going to read one of them, if you would please indulge me. This is Mays Landon. Letter of condolence, Sister Margaret Lois Burroughs, Mrs. McGanza Burroughs Davis and family. Dear Sister McGanza, our hearts were saddened when we heard of the passing of your dear mother Margaret Burroughs on July 27, 2020. Even though we are sorrowful in her passing, we are encouraged knowing that she fought a good fight, finished her course, and kept the faith and is resting from her labor. Mother Burroughs, as we affectionately called her, was very supportive of this ministry. She always made time to visit and show her support to her family. She never failed to have a word of encouragement to share which she interacted. We'll miss her smile, her jovial disposition, and her presence. Mother Burroughs was a faithful participant in our daily prayer and meditation call, proudly announcing herself so we would know she was on the call. We always listened for her to say, "Pray for Margaret Burroughs," or "Pray for your mother." She loved listening to her daughter and granddaughter Tanya pray. Our God is sovereign, therefore, we bow to his perfect will. We extend our heartfelt sympathy to you, G. Leroy, Brian, and Brenda, and the rest of your family, and we're here to assist you in whatever ways we can. Also know that we will continue to pray for you, entire Burroughs family, and God will console and comfort you now in the days to come. Songwriter penned these words, Ask the Savior to help you, comfort, strengthen, and keep you. For he only is able to aid you, and he will carry you through. Blessings, Dr. Wendy A. Mason, Reverend of St. James A.M.E. Church, Mace Landon. And I'm going to also acknowledge there's a letter of condolence from, humbly submitted from Caldwell Money Missionary Society, St. James Church in Mace Landon, Evangelist Charlotte Golden, Missionary Secretary, Reverend Dr. Wendy A. Mason, Pastor. And I'm going to acknowledge the resolution from the Usher Ministry of St. James A.M.E. Church, Mace Landon, Charlene J. Anderson, Acting Secretary, Reverend Dr. Wendy Mason Harris, Pastor, and if St. James A.M.E. Church would please stand. Resolution in memory of Sister Margaret Burroughs. There's a sweet, sweet spirit in this place, and I know that it's the presence of the Lord. Whereas God plucked a beautiful rose, Sister Margaret Lois Burroughs, from her home on Thursday, July 27, 2023, to be in his heavenly garden. And whereas Sister Margaret epitomized the Christian virtues as depicted in Galatians 22-23, love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, and temperance, she instilled in her children the Christian virtues that governed her life. Her daughter Maganza Davis is a devout member of St. James A.M.E. Church in Mace Landon, and her daughter Brenda is a steward and former chair of the Finance Commission here at our beloved St. James. And whereas Sister Margaret was a dedicated member of St. James for over 50 years, working faithfully in the hostess ministry, serving as president for many years, she sang on the Richard Allen Gospel Choir and then a senior choir after they merged. She was affiliated with several fraternal organizations and ascended to the highest ranks in many of them. And whereas she was an exemplary Christian who became one of the Burroughs sisters upon her marriage into the Burroughs family, she and her husband Goldberg lived next door to his sister, Reverend Bernice Prescott. And their extended families enjoyed various outings and group fellowship. Whereas she was one of the nicest people you could ever meet, she genuinely loved people and was revered for her kind ways and sweet spirit. To know her was to love her. We enjoy her sense of humor, her friendship, her humility, and her wit. And whereas we commend you to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who was the master of her life, she will sorely be missed, but she is resting in the arms of God, where no sickness, harm, or trouble can reach her, only the peace and security of heaven. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the pastor, officers, and members of St. James A.M.E. Church Atlantic City extend heartfelt sympathy to her sons, Goldberg Burroughs III, Brian Burroughs, her daughters Maganza and Brenda, her sister-in-laws Lucille, Lillian, and Suzette, her grandchildren, nieces, nephews, godchildren, and other family members and friends. Resolve, let it further be resolved, that a copy of this resolution be given to the Burroughs family and a copy placed in the archives of St. James A.M.E. Church. Your life was a blessing, your memory a treasure. You are loved beyond words and missed beyond measure. Done by the order of Senior Steward Board, Reverend Dr. James Coaxum, the third pastor. Thank you, and family, we love you, and our prayers are with you. Amen. Amen.
Sister Burroughs lived such a full and rich life. Amen. And touched so many people, and certainly we wish we had more time. But we thank and praise God for this time we have right now. We thank and praise God for the acknowledgments that have already been heard. We will now have our obituary reading by Brian Burroughs and a selection, and I'd like to get this pronunciation correct, of Caban, of Caban's ship. Amen.
Passed away peacefully, surrounded by her family and on July 27, 2023. He was born on August 17, 1931, Western Georgia. With Otis Davis. Barbara was the first of three girls, Hazel, John, Fisher Melvin, Debbie Wayne, and then Aunt Lou Jones, Devon David. Graduated Oak Hill High School in Sylvester, Georgia, attended Morris Brown College in Atlanta, Georgia. Received degrees in Carver Technical School of Cosmetology in Atlanta, Georgia. Margaret worked various jobs in New Jersey. Her most rewarding one was being a child caretaker. Called Miss B, 15 years in her home, 5 hours a day. It wasn't about the money, it was about the service. Margaret was in her early 20s, traveled to Atlantic City with her aunt, Gordon. On Atlantic City, that fell in love with Gordon Burroughs. They were married and had 4 months older. Gordon Goldie, El Janet Burroughs, Donald Davis, Ryan L. Burroughs, and Brenda L. Burroughs. Bernadette, grandchildren, Bolsa family, Tyson, Ferroni, Fanya, big grands, Pius, Barry, Bill, Lorena, Davis. One stepdaughter, Robin Stepp, Marvin, Bella, Jason. York Realtor, 12 grandchildren, and 2 great women. Sister-in-law Lucille Kennedy, Blair Reeder, Cease, Lillian Rowe, Bernice Prescott, and Beth Charles. The 2 godchildren and a host of nieces, nephews, and extended family members of both. Margaret has been a member of St. James A.M.E. Church for over years, serving and praising the Lord. Is a member of Hostess Club, has served many years as the president. She was a member of the senior choir and has served as the financial Margaret joined Ozil Chapter, Grand Chapter, Order of Eastern Stars, Prince Hall affiliate in New Jersey. Served as a district deputy grand matron and past matron of Atlantic Chapter number. Years in the past, illustrious managers published Azure Court number 14 and past Imperial Deputy for the Desert of New Jersey, 10 years. Past Royal Commanders of Mount Olive Court number 10 and 10 in the past Maryland of Court number 15. She has traveled and served the community for over 50 plus years. Margaret's faith and commitment goes beyond all others 91 years younger and still has a desire to attend meetings, prayers, phone calls, and work for the Lord, and be a service to others while laughing, watching families, and peace. Family, Brandy. Fight thyself, also in the Lord. So give me fire of my heart, arms 37.
Children, the virtues of being a virtuous woman and having grace and grandeur. As one of the ships, I can truly say my aunt has given us such happiness, such joy for me not to have lived with her, but to just, I guess, be like a guest in her life. I've always known who she was, how she was. My family spoke of her so highly. They never, ever spoke of the sisters that lived here. My Aunt Ruth, that was her aunt, but they were like sisters. They grew up with just like sisters. The old family treated the family as family. And the ship girls, if you ever see one ship, all of them look alike. And it just runs in the family, the love and the charity of their hearts. And on behalf of us, I'd like to say to her, God has you. I miss you. I know they do. And I just pray that I'm able to sing this for her today, because I always call her on her birthday and sing for her. But I'm going to do it today, and you all get to share. And I ask you to pray with me, be with me, because this is really hard. When it's all
continue with this celebration of the life of Mother Margaret Burroughs. We'll now have words of encouragement. And before we go into our words of encouragement, I want to acknowledge the pastor of this house, yeah. Reverend Dr. James Coaxum III. Amen. I thank and praise God for him. As it was already mentioned, Mother Burroughs loved her pastor. Amen. And so I thank God for him. I have a short story that I'd like to share with you before I ask the clergy to come and have a word, but Mother Burroughs was a blessing in my life. When I was here on the pulpit staff at St. James, I had the opportunity at times to serve her communion, amen? But there was one time during COVID that Reverend Coaxum had come up with this ingenious idea, amen, to go around on the church bus and visit our seniors, amen. So I remember that. And we had the opportunity to go into the backyard and have almost had service, amen, with Reverend Prescott and Mother Burroughs. And that's one of the pleasant times that I remember. There are many of them, but that is one of the pleasant times that I remember. And so I just wanted to share that as we continue to encourage this family. Amen. I'd like to acknowledge Minister Jody Burroughs that is here. Amen. And amen. And we thank and praise God for some of the other clergy that is here. Reverend Barbara Spence, if you have a couple words, we would like you to come. Reverend Zena Tompkins, if you have a couple words. Reverend Wendy Mason Harris, amen. And if there's anyone that I miss, please make me aware. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everyone.
Praise the Lord.
Let the church say, hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Giving honor to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who is amazing. He is omnipotent, he is awesome. Giving honor to my pastor and all of the clergy that's present. Giving honor to the Burrow family and friends and all loved ones this morning, this afternoon. God is good and God is ready to be praised, amen. Lord knows I love Margaret Burroughs, amen. She exhibited the fruit of the Spirit, amen. She had love and, well, I'm standing behind the sacred desk. She worked on self-control, amen. Amen. But to God be the glory, amen. Amen. She was a great friend, a great driving along, coming back and forth to choir rehearsal, how we joked and cut up. And she always had a laugh in her soul, and we just thank God for her. So on behalf of my family, the Walker, the Spence family, I offer my profound condolences, knowing that God is going to watch over you every step of the way. Though you go through the valleys of the shadows of death, no, my sisters and brothers, it's only a shadow. God be with you.
Yeah. Giving honor to God and this great shepherd of this house, Reverend Coaxum, and all the clergy that are attending, I just got words of encouragement, of absent from the body means present with the Lord. And we know where Sister Margaret Burroughs is. And she was an encourager, and I loved her sly sense of humor. And I just know as a one who lost her mother, and to those that are present, I've lost Sister Margaret Burroughs, be encouraged. She already laid the groundwork and the foundation for your family, for the love to, and unity to go on. And just follow the words that she had said to you. Follow the good times that she encouraged you to have, and you will be going in the right direction. But most of all, follow the God that she followed through his son, Jesus Christ. And you will make it through this time of sorrow. Be encouraged. God bless.
And if you step down the line and she heard something going on, she would take you to the side. Come on, I need to talk to you. And she would give you some guidance. She truly loved you. She cared about your heart. She cared about your soul. She cared about where you're going. And she would help you in whatever you needed to do. She helped watch your children. Your bad, bad kid. She had the cutest little bat. It was like this. It was a rubber one. And all she had to do was shake and the kids took off. I don't know why I didn't hurt nobody. But I know that was fun playing. But you guys, you have to just know that, I know when my mother passed away, one thing we did do, Sarah put on some praise music, and we just ran around the room, and we sang, and we praised the Lord. And sometimes when you're feeling really sad and low, that's what you need to do. Sometimes when you pray and you feel that you're not getting a breakthrough, you need to praise the Lord, and the breakthrough will come through. Just remember that God always loves you and He cares for you. Just remember every single prayer she prayed for you, it's still in that bowl. It doesn't get answered sometimes soon, sometimes maybe, sometimes later. It's not on our time schedule, it's on God's time schedule. But make sure your heart is in order. Because things are a whole lot easier with God than they are without Him. I can't imagine living life the way it is, as crazy as it's been going lately, without God. Just lean on Him, trust in Him, and He will guide your every path. He loves you. She's just sleeping. When we go to meet our Father, our Heavenly Father, she'll greet you and she'll be there. It's just a little bit of time we have to wait. Just know that. Love you guys.
The blood that Jesus shed on Calvary's cross, it will never lose its power. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Go burn Leroy and Janet, Nicole, Jemias, Kabila, Jameson, Maganza, Tyrone, Tanya, Lauren, Brian, Savannah, Tyson, Corey, Brenda, and Bernadette, Robin, Marvin, and Sheila, Amanda, Amira, Amani, Amir Jr., Fabian, Parissa, Paris, Fabian Jr., Nastia, Anari, Raytrella, and Ernest, Dayor, Darnell, Jason, Malan, Evan, Sisters Hazel and Ann Lou, Sisters-in-law, Lucille, Lillian, and Suzette, brother-in-law, Charles, nieces, nephews, and cousins. Your mommy, your grandmommy, your great-grandmommy, your sister-in-law, your auntie, your godmommy, your church family, spiritual daughter, and your sisters of Atlantic Chapter Number 3, OESPHA. Margaret Lois Burroughs was truly the matriarch in the family. Auntie not only took care of your needs, but she also provided you with spiritual wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of who Jesus is. Throughout her life, she placed her trust and faith in God's holy word. She loved reading the Bible, memorizing scriptures, and reciting them to us as a guide to our life journey with the Lord. Auntie taught us so much about life and how to be true to one's own principles, respect, and to love one another unconditionally. She touched so many lives, wore so many hats. Whenever we strayed, your mommy gently and firmly brought us back to the Lord. When we needed comfort, your mommy was always there to wipe away our tears. Whenever we were at a crossroad in our lives, Auntie shared the insight she had learned from Jesus. You always knew you could depend on your mom whenever you needed her help. You also knew that she loved her family unconditionally. What a joy Auntie was to all of us. So full of energy and life, always traveling here and there with her family. All the balls, events, formal gatherings, conventions, parties, morning after morning and afternoon church service to hear her pastor preach. Aunt Lolo loved Power Month Bible study and movie in the afternoon that we had at my house, that was had at my house, along with my mom, Aunt Gigi, Aunt Bern, Aunt Lily, Keisha, Reverend Spence, and Hattie, and other family members and friends who, and we had plenty of snacks and food. The Bible said, Matthew 5:4, blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. John 11:35, Jesus wept. Your mommy had left a mark on all of us. We were so grateful for her gracious love, devotion, generosity, dedication, her hospitality, and her genuine spirit. Sadness fills our heavy hearts because she is no longer with us. We always miss her beautiful smile, telling us how much she loved us. We will truly miss her sitting in her favorite chair, sleeping peacefully in her bed, cooking those delicious meals, her tender affections, spending time and teaching her grands and great-grands all about Jesus, encouraging them, telling them how smart, pretty, or handsome they were, and rocking her babies to sleep. We have a treasure chest of wonderful, beautiful memories that we'll cherish in our hearts. But we know that she is safe in the arms of the Lord, and that gives us abiding comfort and peace, knowing she is resting with the Lord. She is loved, she is missed, and we will always honor her in our prayers. The Bible also says, 2 Corinthians, we are confident, yes, well pleased rather to be absent from the body and present with the Lord. John 14:2-4, in my Father's house there are many mansions. If it was not so, I would have told you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, and where I am, there you may be also. 1 Corinthians 15:55, O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? If the strength of sin is the law, but thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Aunt Lola was a beautiful, blessed, anointed, spiritual, Proverbs 31 praying woman of God who was fearfully and wonderfully made and highly favored in the Lord. Until we meet again, Psalms 115:118, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his face. God bless you, family and friends. May God continue to comfort you and give us the peace that surpasses all understanding. Continue to sleep in sweet heavenly peace and love till we meet again. Amen.
Ask you to bear with me as I walk through this real quick. So as a kid, we used to drive down here with my mom and dad, but often with my mom, and this is how the drive would go as a kid. So she would pack us up in the station wagon, and we would go to Uncle Butch and Aunt Sue's house. We would get in the pool, and then we'll hang out with Cousin Suzette. They weren't home, we would sneak in the pool, and then do that and perhaps get in trouble later. And then we would drive down, we'd go to Aunt Lil's house, and then we'd hang out with the cousins. And then we'd drive into Atlantic City, we'd go to Granny and Pop Pop's house. And then we'd go a few doors down to Uncle Jim and Aunt G's house, hang out with the cousins. And then we'd go to my dad's mom's house, Nana and Pop Pop. And then we'd go to my dad's sister's house, Aunt Fanny, and hang out with the cousins. Then we'd go to Aunt B's house, hang out with Aunt B and Uncle Stan and the cousins. And then we started heading back, go to Uncle Ken and Aunt Burns' house, hang out with the cousins. They had the very convenient location. One family's over here, one house is over there. And then we end up with Uncle Bun and Aunt Lowe's house, hang out with Leroy, Maganza, Brenda, get in trouble with my brother and I, Howard and I, with Brian. All right, I'll just see why we got in trouble. Leave that alone, Brian. So anyway, you know, I got to hear Aunt Lo call Uncle Bun, Bun, Buddy, Goldburn. I only heard him call her Lo. Was there anything else he called her?
Ben.
Okay, all right. And you know, so why did I walk through that? I walked through that because we were shown as kids relationships. We were shown as kids family. And that family matters, that family love matters, and that family and significant relationships are so very important. So as I got older and come down here on business, and or come down on our brother's trip, my brother Howard, my brother Tim, my brother Paul, we would do the same route and visit the aunts, visit the family, because we were taught that as a kid. So Brian, and then often we would come down, we would FaceTime my aunt Lo's goddaughter, Shay, from Florida, let her see her godmother and her aunt as well, because we knew how important, and she knew how important that was. But most important thing that I want to express today is that if you have significant relationships, if you have significant family relationships, to embrace them fully, to nurture them, because they are truly a gift from God. Brian, Leroy, Maganza, Brenda, and the grandkids, we love you dearly. God bless you.
Praise the Lord, everybody. I know my name's not on there, but they asked me and I got it all together, and maybe I told you I'd go last minute. But anyway, on behalf of the Stratton family, we thank God for Auntie. She was loving, she was kind, she had a sense of humor. She always liked every time I would come to next door, I had to go to see her. Like it was, you know, you couldn't do one without the other. And I would always go over there and I said, Auntie, you need anything? She said, no, just sit down and talk to me. But through our family, she taught us about her good cooking. Somebody in our family was snapping peas and cleaning collard greens and shucking corn. Joey used to get in trouble all the time, and Aunt Lolo used to look out the window and say, if you and Kenny don't stop that, I'm going to tell. But I'm trying to warn y'all before y'all get in trouble. So, and Marvella, she remembers Auntie from the gatherings. Every time we got together, Auntie was there. Always sitting there, and each one of us would go around and talk to our aunties and talk to the families. We always got together, and family, we need to get together. Yeah. We need to get together quickly. But I just want to encourage you that, you know, life changes every single day. But what God has given us from our parents and from our family will never go away. I love you all. Be blessed in the Lord and keep serving Him, because without Him we can do nothing. But with God, all things are possible. So whatever you need, it's in serving Jesus. Amen.
God bless, God bless, God bless. These are hard acts to follow. I just want to bless God for favor today. Favor of putting this young lady in my life. And then adding to that by making her family. Okay? God always gives us more than we deserve. And when I speak about one aunt, there's a collective. I love Aunt Lolo, and I'm her favorite. Wait. I say that not in sarcasm or in gloating, but they all had the unique ability to show us that we were, each one collectively, their favorites. So when I say that, it gives me something deep down inside. When Charlotte was talking about love. All of them show love as an action. Okay? And with getting that, seeing that, learning that, it allows us to do the same. So the love they gave us taught me how to love. I don't know about anybody else, but I'm sure probably did. And it helped me so much as an adult that I didn't know really what I was missing out on. So I just found out recently that a friend of mine's kids were watched, babysat by Aunt Lola. And I see as the love, the encouragement, the influence that she has on us, she imparts to others. And I don't know about anybody else, but when I spend time with people and we connect, they become family. So with that connection and the growth of those other connections that are outside our immediate family, we all become family. So I'm saying that to say, as we look around, we're all connected somehow, some way, to this lady, this family, and goes way back there. And extends to this side of the church. Even though it's separated by family and others, we're family. I love you. I'm here with, if you need me, and if you don't need me, I'm here. Okay? I was going to tell a story. I'm going to tell it. So, Aunt Lolo and Mom used to always get together. When there was some kind of affair or something, they would always get together. Aunt Lolo would always come over. So, I'm 7-ish. And my mom's rule was, if the door's closed, you knock and wait for the answer, for the bedroom door. So this day, I knocked and pushed in and stopped dead in my tracks because on the dresser were these styrofoam heads with hair on them. And I freaked out. Because I saw them, they had the stocking caps on, and in my science fiction brain set, aliens had come and took my aunt and my mom. I turned and ran out. All of a sudden, they're chasing me, like trying to, no, because I don't recognize you. So I went out in the backyard, hid out, and yeah, that's one of my favorite stories that I'll remember forever. So I love you guys. God bless you. I love you.
Amen. Amen. What a testament of a beautiful life. Hold on to those wonderful memories. God has had God's hand on Margaret Burroughs. Amen. And so we thank and praise God for her life. We will now have a selection from Tanya Davis.
Everybody knows me as the funny one. I am the funny. But this is hard for me. My grandma was my best friend. When a lot of people, I thought, turned their back on me, she was there. No disrespect to anybody, but that's my grandma. The only one. She had friends, family, but that was my grandma. This is hard for me, because I couldn't understand why the man upstairs kept taking pieces of it. Took my grandma, took my brother, took a lot of people from me, and it's hard for me. And I just want you to know that I love you, and I love all you, and if I ever did anything to hurt you, I'm sorry. I was young, I was dumb. But I love you, girl, and I love you all.
In my grandma's last moments, I couldn't stop thanking her for everything that she did. And I want to continue thanking her today. Grandma, thank you for teaching me how to be a lady, because training definitely starts at home. This little one. But as a little girl, when I would sit on the couch, anytime I sat with my legs up on the couch, she would knock them down. She would go past, knock them down. Watching TV, knock them down. She would, like, don't sit like that. Sit up and wait. So I thank her for that. I thank you for teaching me how to be honest. Because if I ever asked her to help me with just like the littlest white lie, she would say, don't have them call me because I'm not lying. I'm not doing it for you. I'm not doing it. Thank you. I thank you, Grandma, for teaching me how to cook without actually teaching me how to cook. I just learned from watching. Because when she cooked, I sat at the kitchen table and that's when we had conversations. Thank you for teaching me how to be a friend. Her friendships meant everything to her. She couldn't wait to get on the phone and talk to one of her sisters and start laughing. Her friends never changed. It was like clockwork. 9 a.m. she would go out with Miss Harewood. 10 a.m. Aunt Byrne called. Around dinner time, Miss Mays called. And then she would wrap it up with Aunt Louie and Aunt Lou. Thank you for showing me what unconditional love looked like. Watching the relationship she had with my grandfather was beautiful. She loved him and only him until the day that she died. And I know that both of them are up there grinning right now, and I want them to behave, because I know they miss each other. Thank you for showing me how to love and trust in God. She took me to church every day when I was a little girl, and I got all the leg tensions just like she is today. And when I didn't go to church, she made sure I heard the daily word. When I would sit to eat breakfast, she would say, okay, you got your breakfast. All right, let me tell you something. And then she would bust her book out and start reading it to me. But what I'm really going to miss are all the prayers that she gave us and a hug. And that's when she would provide her comfort. Thank you for teaching me how to be a mother. Thank you for the guidance. She guided me so good sometimes that I had to remind her that Jeremias was my son. But I didn't mind because I knew that the kids gave her life. She said she got too old to help with the last two, but she would always say, I wish I was younger so I could keep them. So I would always bring them over so she could love on them. And she was the only woman I knew who could train a child and an animal from her chair. Especially Bubba. All she needed was a back scratcher, a cane, a bat, a shoe, a wooden spoon. But she did it from her chair. So thank you, Grandma, for showing me the power of a queen on her throne. I'm going to take everything that she instilled in me and I'm going to pour it to my kids. One last time for sharing your love with us. Not just me, but all of us. I thank God for being here today and just a wonderful service, ongoing service for Grandma. And just really quickly, I call my grandma Birmingham because one day as we were sitting in the living room, we kept talking about, she's my grandma, no, she's my grandma. And then we kept saying it so many times, it sounded like Birmingham. And I said, Grandma, that's what I'm calling you from now on. You're my Birmingham. And she said, okay. And she didn't mind. Anytime I seen her, if I didn't call her, then she said, you didn't call Birmingham today. And I'm like, I'm sorry, Grandma, I'm going to give you a call. And
I would come over and do her hair, and we would just have so much fun talking and laughing, and I just enjoyed doing it. I would tell her, Grandma, can you just wait once a month to get your hair redone? And she'd be like, yeah. And then in 2 weeks, she's taking the hair out, get somebody to come over and take it. I'm like, Grandma. And we would tell her, just wait a couple more weeks. But she wanted her hair out. She loved when people would compliment her hair and wear something new. And I just love doing it for her. And I love singing with her and praying with her and watching her read her Bible every morning and drink her tea. And I just love when I would praise dance or if I would sing and I would be so nervous. I would close my eyes as I would praise dance or sing, and I would come over and sit next to her, and she would just hug me and be like, great job. I'm so proud of you. And I would just be so happy. So anytime I would dance or sing, I'm going to miss that, and I just know that she is smiling on us. And I just want to sing this song because we sang it in the hospital when they thought she was going out of her mind and they thought she wasn't able to be in her right consciousness. I was like, no, she's still here. Let me show you. So we would hold hands and we would pray, and then we would start singing. And if you can sing with me to help through this song. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today. Thank you.
preserved the life of Sister Margaret Burroughs. God, we thank you for 91 years. 91 years of living, oh God. 91 years of service. 91 years of mothering and grandmothering and great-grandmothering. God, we thank you for her life. Now as we've come to bring a word of comfort to this family, God, it's not about me, but it's all about you. So hide me behind your cross as you speak to your people here. And we will never forget to give you honor, glory, and praise. These and other blessings we ask in your name. The children of God say amen and amen. Amen. Certainly, we want to say to this family, I am honored to really have this opportunity to speak on behalf of one who's meant so much to so many people. Sister Margaret Burroughs. Somebody ought to say amen again for 91 years. Amen. Many of you know her birthday is August 17th, and my birthday is August 18th. So I already know she's good people. Somebody ought to say amen. Because all good people are born in the month of August. And if you don't believe that, you see me at the church and we'll work it on out. Amen? Amen. I do want to, before I really kind of get too far in, I want to acknowledge because Sister Burroughs has two sisters. One who is here with us, and I believe one who is, watching. And we do want to acknowledge her sister who could not make it. And we want to offer our condolences. We want you to know that we're praying for you. And to her sister who's here, we want you to know that we continue to lift you up because we know there's nothing like sisterhood. Amen? Amen. And if not for the sisters in Georgia, we know that here, there was a set of sisters. Somebody say sisters. We call them the Burroughs sisters. And there was no such thing as in-law. They were just all Burroughs sisters. And we've got a pew over there, and I call it the Burroughs pew. As a matter of fact, a couple pews, because there was a time when you looked on that pew, they were all Burroughs sisters. Somebody ought to say amen. And so you already know that that was a praising pew. Amen? And we thank God that, as we think about the legacy of Reverend Prescott, as we think about the legacy of Sister Valair, that there are those who have come from other generations, amen, to make sure that they take their place on that pew, amen. So Sister Martine, make sure, she's moving from the pew to the pulpit, but when she's not there, Sister Monique, amen, has got her place on the Burroughs pew. Sister Kathy, amen, I didn't know Sister Kathy can sing, amen. Sister Kathy has been here every Sunday in church. Now we got to get her up on the choir, but she's been on the Burroughs pew. Somebody to say amen. Sister Lillian came on Mother's Day herself, escorted by Charlotte, and she came and took her place on the Burroughs pew. Sister Lillian, it's so good to see you. Amen. And Brother Martin, we know that y'all are busy, amen, over at the church, right across the street. But every once in a while, amen, you got to send somebody to represent your mom too. Amen. The Lord's name be praised, because there was a time that I looked out and they were all sitting there praising God. And when the pastor preach, you look at the folk who gonna say amen, amen. And so I could always count on the Burroughs pew because I was know I was gonna get an amen, I was gonna get a tambourine shake, or just a little hand wave as Sister Margaret Burroughs would do. Somebody ought to say amen today. And so, yes, Reverend Wendy, she had two memberships. And when I would go to see her, she would sometimes act like, oh, they had me at the other St. James today. And I wanted to be in my own church. But then she would say, but I'm just happy to be in church. And so we are grateful that, she couldn't go wrong. Amen. Amen. She had St. James on one side and St. James on the other side. And so we certainly, share her. And one of the things I want to say is I really, really got to know Sister Burroughs over the past few years, having the opportunity to make communion visitations and to have personal one-on-one conversations. We really, really had the opportunity to get to know each other. And yes, she was sassy. And I would go sometimes and, she would have her hair braided. I said, Sister Burroughs, you got braids? And it was looking good. And she would put her hand up to her hair and everything like that and turn her head and make the pastor laugh. But we just thank God for good memories that we have. And as I thought about where I would land in terms of a message for today, how could I not turn to Proverbs 31? When I think about the life of Sister Margaret Burroughs, let me ask you, during your quiet moments, all mothers should read about this woman in Proverbs 31. And it really starts in verse 10, and we're going to read some selected verses, but during your quiet moments, we ask you to read from verse 10 all the way to verse 31, because it all constitutes the context out of which we shall attempt to preach today. It says, a good wife who can find? She is far more precious than jewels. The heart of her husband trusts in her, and he will have no lack of gain. She does him good and not harm all the days of her life. She seeks wool and flax and works with willing hands. She is like the ships of the merchant. She brings her food from afar. She rises while it is yet night and provides food for her household and tasks for her maidens. She considers a field and buys it. With fruit in her hands, she plants a vineyard. She girdeth her loins with strength and makes her arms strong. She perceives that her merchandise is profitable. Her lamp does not go out at night. Somebody ought to say amen. She puts her hands to the distaff and her hands to the spindle. She opens her hands to the poor and reaches out her hands to the needy. She is not afraid of the snow of her household, for all of her household are clothed in scarlet. She makes herself coverings. Her clothing is fine linen and purple. Her husband is known in the gates when he sits among the elders. And I'm going to skip down to verse 28. Her children rise up and call her blessed. And I want to pause right there, and I'd like to put a tag on that text. And for the next few moments with your prayers, I'd like to use as a subject from which to preach, remembering a virtuous mother. Remembering a virtuous mother. Why don't you turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor,
neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh neighbor,
there is nothing like a virtuous mother. Why don't you turn to another neighbor and say, neighbor,
neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh neighbor,
there is nothing like a virtuous mother. Now if you believe it, you ought to put your hands together and give the Lord some glory. When we come to moments like this, I often say there's a mystery to motherhood. When we think about our mothers, isn't it amazing how our mothers pay attention to the closest details in our lives? It's as if our mothers don't miss anything that happens to us. If we're not in the right mood, they know. And if we're feeling a little frustrated, they know. It's often like our mother feels our pain. In many ways, mothers symbolize the way God pays attention to every believer. He watches, he observes, and he appreciates the countless small things as he assesses our lives. As Christians, we are glad to know that God knows all about us, that he knows even the number of hairs on our heads. And certainly as we look at this text today, and as we think of the life of Sister Margaret Burroughs, we can say that she was and is a virtuous mother. When we look at the text says her children will rise up and call her blessed. And have not you done that today and all week long? And we thank you for taking care of your mother during her illness, because you have shown that children do come back and take care of their parents. And even when children are grown, our mothers are still mothers. They remember our graduations, our anniversaries, our birthdays. They still buy us cards. They look back in the old photo albums and remind us of the yesteryear. When we think about it, we miss the little things that our mothers really provide for us. Because when all else fails, we can count on words from our mothers to get us through. Sometimes it's the laughter, the good times, the jokes, the goofy things that makes a family. But have we not demonstrated here today that this matriarch leaves behind a strong family with strong family ties? And when we look at it in a real sense, I will say that she had what I consider to be called a mom ministry. Some of you haven't heard about the mom ministry, have you? And so let me tell you about the mom's ministry. You think some of the ministries in the church are tough? Ain't nothing like the mom ministry. You see, the mom ministry is one of the toughest assignments that God has ever given to anybody. Why is it, Pastor? Because, look at this. Our mothers have to be insightful as a psychologist. They have to be as tough as a Marine Corps drill instructor. They also have to be as gentle as a nurse. But when we look at our mothers, can't we say that they are managers, they are negotiators, they are teachers, they are electricians, they are plumbers, and they are carpenters. Our mothers have done it all. And yes, you can say my mom was old school. Well, what does that mean, Pastor? I'm so glad you asked. In other words, your mom was, she wanted to make sure that you had food to eat here on earth. But she was also concerned about you being fed the word of God, because she knows that the word of God would carry you all the days of your life. Yes, our mothers are concerned with clothes on our back, but she's also concerned about the fact that we're putting on the breastplate of righteousness and the helmet of salvation. Yes, our mothers are concerned that we have a place called home, but our mothers know that there's no home like God's heaven. Is there a witness in the house? And when we think about our mothers being touched by the old school values, as we sang that hymn this morning, blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Is that not the testimony of black mothers throughout the century, that this is my story, this is my song? We want to praise your name all the day long. And I can remember my communion visits with Sister Margaret Burroughs, and we would often sing that song before I would give her communion. And sometimes when we got to the chorus, she would shed a tear or two, and sometimes she would just say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And I come to let you know that yes, Sister Margaret was a praiser. When I went to visit her, I can feel it on the inside. And so yes, we've come to remember the life of this virtual mother, of this virtuous mother, because our mothers have done it all. They know how to grow strong families. They know how to feed a big family. They put together some cornbread, a little somewhat now, but they knew how to save money without going to the bank. Is there a witness in the house? So that whenever you need something, mama didn't have to run to the bank, but she could run to the cupboard, wherever she kept her money, and make sure that you had what you needed. And so if you give me just a couple more minutes, I want to walk around this text, and I want to pick up some principles to help you to understand that Sister Burroughs, yes, is a virtuous mother. You see, today there are so many great women in the world, but not everyone can live up to being a virtuous woman. One of the first characteristics when we look at a virtuous mother is that they are women who fear the Lord. Tell somebody, they fear the Lord. And what you've got to understand about that is because they fear the Lord, they're not anxious about the future. You see, the woman who trust in the Lord doesn't worry about the future, but they're content with the things that God allowed them to have right now. I can remember many Sundays on the senior choir, they would sing that song, I don't know about tomorrow. I just live from day to day. I don't borrow from its sunshine, for its clouds may turn to gray. I don't worry over future, for I know what Jesus said, and today I walk beside him. Many things about tomorrow I don't seem to understand, but I know who holds tomorrow, and I know who holds my hand. I've come by to let you know that Sister Burroughs wasn't anxious for anything, but she knew the Lord that she served, and she would always say, I trust in God wherever I might be. And that's not all, but our mothers, they lived by practical wisdom. Tell somebody, practical wisdom. When we look at how we live our lives now, it's often mother talking in our head, reminding us of the practical wisdom that she has given unto us. And many times I talk about this practical wisdom on Mother's Day. I've come to suggest to Hallmark that they need a section in the card store for to capture all of the sayings that has been handed down over the years. You know what I'm talking about. Mother taught you that a bird in the hand is worth two in the bush. Is there a witness in the house? Yes, Mother taught us that if we lay down with dogs, that we get up with fleas. Yes, just the practical wisdom our mothers lived by. They would say, waste not, want not. And what that meant to me is you better eat all vegetables off of your plate. Is there a witness in the house? And we also know that our mothers have that thing that's called the look. And I know Sister Brandy, y'all knew about it. Just like sometimes your mom might be singing in the choir, but if you're not doing what you were supposed to do in the pew, from the choir loft all the way down to the church, mom would give you that look. And that look means, man, that you better straighten up. Otherwise, when we get out of church, and some of your mothers wouldn't even wait till you get out of church, but they would take you downstairs to the bathroom, and they would have just a little talk with you while the church was talking with Jesus. And by the time you came back in church, you knew how to sit still. You knew how to keep still, because mom wasn't going to say it twice. And so we thank God for the practical wisdom. And you said it today. Yes, Mother Burroughs, she can raise a child in her chair, because it's the look that they got. And when they give you that look, you know it's time to get things right. But can I tell you something else about this virtuous woman? She was strong. You see, it says women who fear the Lord are strong. And we know, I'm not really talking about physical strength, but can I talk about that for just a little bit? Because we know that in her latter years, yes, Sister Burroughs was strong. There's some doctors and nurses down at the Atlantic City Hospital who will remember that you don't be poking on our mother's body any old kind of way. If they're witness in the house, I mean, I understand Sister Burroughs has got a mean back hand. If there's a nurse who saw the back of that hand, they thought they were going to poke on her body any kind of way. Oh no, they won't touch God's temple any kind of way. And she didn't want to be touched just by everybody. And so yes, Sister McGansa, she was strong. You didn't know when she grabbed your hand that she could squeeze it that tight. But I've come by to let you know that women who fear the Lord, not only is there a physical strength, but I've come by to let you know there's a spiritual strength, because they're standing on the promises of Jesus. And how could a matriarch leave a legacy like this behind? Only standing on the promises of Jesus. And I've come by to let you know that when I look at the life of Sister Burroughs, I've come to let you know that she lived for others rather than living for herself. If there are witnesses in the house, I'll say it one more time. She lived for others rather than living for herself. And I've come to let you know this pastor is going to miss Sister Burroughs, because we had our own inside jokes. Every now, Dr. Hyde, when she would sing on the senior choir and she would sit right somewhere next to Dr. Hyde, I would joke with her at the senior choir party and say, Sister Burroughs, I'm going to call on you to do a solo. And she said, go right ahead, and I'm going to take the hymn book and I'm going to hit you on the back of your head before you preach. Somebody said, amen. drive-by service. And when we went there, Reverend Prescott, we were supposed to be there for just a couple minutes. Reverend Prescott said, oh, they told me y'all were coming by to have church. We talked to Sister Margaret. Sister Margaret said, they told us you were having a church service today. And we said, no, we weren't coming to have a whole church service, but we just wanted to come by and visit. But you know how Reverend Prescott is. I want to let you know, We had church between the two homes. If you're a witness in the house, and can I tell you something that I take away from Sister Burroughs? You see, when I talk about Reverend Prescott and Sister Belair, I call them the Tamarine twins. But Reverend Prescott would double back, because Reverend Prescott sometimes would have a cane. And so on the Sunday that we did the drive-by, I had a little accident on the parking lot. And Sister Martine gave me the cane, a Sister Belair. And so I had a borrowed cane. And so when I went to the house of Reverend Prescott and Sister Margaret, they started setting up a church. They had them putting chairs out in the yard. And so I looked at the members of the church, and I said, well, I guess we're going to have church today. Because Reverend Prescott said, set it up for church. And but you know what Brenda did? She went and got a chair. And because I had a cane, she set me next to Reverend Prescott. And next to Sister Margaret, and the three of us, we were sitting there with our canes. And they started singing, and I want you to know, I didn't know you could praise God with a cane. But what they told me is that if you can't walk, whatever you've got, you give God your best praise. And as I sat there, I look at Reverend Prescott, I look at Sister Margaret, and when the Spirit got good, they started lifting up those canes. And can you see Pastor Coaxum on the canvas? I didn't walk the pulpit like I want to, because I was outside, my legs were swollen, but I had a cane in my hand, and when I saw them lifted up, I said, hallelujah to God, be the glory with things he can do. And so family, I've come by to let you know, Sister Margaret is in a better place. Release her and let her go. She's lived 91 years, and this I know from going to see her. I've come to let you know that she was ready. Yes, Sister Brenda and I started talking about a 92nd birthday, but Sister Burroughs had other plans. She didn't want to spend her 92nd birthday here, but she decided that she was going to go on up to heaven. And although we're shedding tears down here, can you imagine what's going on in heaven? Can you see the Tamarine twins? Can you see the Cain twins? To let you know, as it's already been said today by Sister Noreen Bailey, whatever you have going on, if you can just learn how to praise your way through it. Because see, that's what the Burroughs sister
just a closer walk with thee.
Strong. Praise pastor and movement, Reverend Dr. Coaxum, to the choir, musicians, to the ushers, and to all of you who have assembled here today in memory and in honor of Mrs. Burroughs. We say thank you for joining us today. At this time, we will be making our journey to the Atlantic City Cemetery, located in Pleasantville, New Jersey. We are asking that if you are going with us, that you would go directly to your automobiles, that you would turn on your hazards and your high beams, and that you would affix a funeral tag to your dashboard, which will signal that you are a part of the funeral procession. We also ask that if you are so inclined, that you would join us back here for a repast that has been prepared, where you can continue to honor the life of Mrs. Burroughs. At this time, we are going to call for any lady that is willing and able to take a full arrangement to move to the front at this time. As you meet us in the front of the church, we're also going to ask all of our pallbearers to meet us in this